Okay, today, YouTube, we're gonna play some more black-white tokens. Decided, or black-white, I guess, history mania slash vehicles. Decided to change a couple things up. I decided to cut the tool-crafted exemplars because they fared pretty weak overall. They don't play defense, and it was kind of poor having eight creatures in the deck that don't play any defense when red-black is probably just a better aggro deck than this deck is. So I think if you want to play this deck, you need to like slow it down and turn it into more of a, like a board control mid-range deck. So with cutting the toolcrafts, we got room for four Fatal Pushes, two Castouts and two Exelon's Bindings, and an Angel of Sanction in the main deck, and a third Gideon of Trials. So then we went up a land in order to just, this deck's very mana hungry, so it's nice just having the another land. Going over the sideboard. I've been working a lot with the sideboard. I really like these sky ships. I bring these in a lot against the green decks, which are kind of tough matchups. I cut the fumigates because what I don't really like with the fumigates is oftentimes I bring an Angel of Sanctions in with the fumigates, and it's just kind of a nombo. So decided to use like Sky Sovereign to help control the board, and Angel of Sanctions help control the board, but one settle, just, you know, to be able to deal with like a hazard or something like that. But we're gonna jump into the games here. I'm already set up and in a league. So we're gonna jump in for the first one. Put my computer glasses on. I'm gonna just clean these glasses up a little bit. Can't see anything with these on. Glasses are so dirty. For round one, decks that I've noticed are pretty hard when playing this deck is I've gotten pretty beat up by all the Gates of the Afterlight decks. So that's been a pretty tough matchup. I'm gonna play, which is nice. I would like to play first, and this hand's good. We're gonna have to hit some land drops, but we have a payoff, a little bit of some removal so we don't get run out the gym, a little bit of grindy, and then our biggest and best threat, probably. Best offensive threat. Give me 1 second. My opponent is thinking about whether they want to keep their hand or not. It's probably not very good against a control deck because this is basically a mulligan of 5. The only thing that Fatal Push really does is kill our own Scrap Heap Scrounger against the control decks, which is not great. Hopefully my opponent gives me like a Soul Scar Mage to kill here. That'd be nice. Alright, so we basically have mulligan to 5. Okay, so I'm going to play the Scrap Heap Scrounger because if I hit a land, I'm going to want to play this History of Vanalia, and then that still gives me an attack. I did not hit a land. We play 25 of them. My opponent seal aways this. We're just going to let it go because we don't have another creature to bring back. Then I'm just going to play this. So we get seal awayed. I'm going to play this Heart. The tough part here is that we are at least 2 turns away from Karn, and we're not going to be able to get an attack in next turn, so it's going to be tough to... Oh, they're cycling, which is good for the home team. Lucky. Tilt. At least if this resolves, we get an attack in. But tough way here. We're on the play, our opponent mulligans. This is how it goes down. I really like this knight right now. I thought about playing the white knight also. I might end up playing the white knight in future games. But I just don't have it right now. I'm slowly chugging their way up. So I guess I'm going to attack first. Because we don't, it's not like we can hit a Toolcraft exemplar. I'm just not give my opponent the information. It's amazing how good this card is here against this deck. Like this 1/2, like all these creatures are very good against this deck. Be sick if they disallowed that. I mean, they don't have it up, but it still would have been so savage if they they'd have been able to and disallowed my my cycle trigger. What is this? So it's a fairy. Okay. It's not good. Gonna hope to get this league done before the Cavs game starts tonight. So we're gonna start like this, and I think I'm actually just going to try and finish it off post-combat with Ballista. My opponent has a Gideon's Reproach, and this is pretty bad. But my opponent's still getting a lot of value here, because we're gonna end up there, like this Teferi's gonna draw a card, then basically trade with an attack step and my walking ballista. Providing it resolves. My opponent could have Essence Scatter would be bad. But it's kinda what we gotta do. Looks like they got it. Yeah, that's not good. We don't get this Teferi off the board this turn. This game's probably gone too far. Glimmering on the main phase. Oh, that's because they're going to untap some lands. So they can still settle me too. Which is okay. I mean, if we get settled, then we get settled. If we hit a land, then we can Ixalan's Binding this after we get settled. And we wouldn't mind being settled here. Jeez. So I'm actually going to play this knight. Crew up here. Our hand's so mana hungry that I'm just going to be okay here getting settled the wreckage, because we need the lands at this point. Yep. We need the resources, and then we can then attack with this Knight of Malice again next turn. And if that doesn't work, we'll probably have to try to Ixalan's Binding this. If it does work, then probably play the History, not the Karn. Just kind of a tough spot. Kind of main phase, the Pull from Tomorrow. All right, this is a Pull from Tomorrow, then we're good here. They cast an Approach. It's probably just as good. Alright, well now we're going to go, because we got to get some damage in here, so I'm going to see if I can hit this right now. I don't think with that, them just resolving that Approach, I think we are pretty dead. Teferi plus Approach is nice. It's just nice that, you know, you're not tapping out on 7, you're pseudo tapping out on 7. Search for his Kanta. So we have a line to win. It's going to be just Karn ticking down. And I don't even think that that's going to be quite quick enough. No, this gets countered. We're just going to scoop it up. Okay. Because they're basically moving two cards a turn towards that Approach, and they have this Memorial to get even closer to it quicker. So, okay, so we're gonna bring in our Duresses. I have a sideboard dive here set up for what I want to do here. So we're cutting our pushes, cutting our Lyras. One ballista. I like having the one ballista for the out, but it is pretty narrow overall. One angel, because they have a lot of ways to, like, if we O-ring something, it's important with the angel, and they have a removal, it's not great. We can board out the planes, because we're going to go along. I want the four duresses, the eldest reborn, the doomfall, the two ardles, the two invoke the divine, and then I cut one more card here. Two light one ballista. And then one Gideon goes as well. Okay. We're actually lowering our curve a little bit, so it doesn't even hurt that much to get rid of the land. We'll grab some water before the next game. Like to play first. Hopefully we have an So with how mana hungry this deck is, I really do like keeping most hands with quite a bit of lands. Scrounge is a decent threat, and we have Karn. I think I'm gonna keep this hand. We have a lot of good live draws, and I just like Karn's a really big key to winning this game. And we have a resilient threat. So, this could go wrong, though. I just like having the lands. But if I don't want to draw anymore, and we did. So now we're in a lot of trouble. Drawing a land was bad. I mean, like, that's you know, the risk that you take. History of Benalia off the top would be gas. All right, Gideon is also very good. So I'm going to serve in here. Gideon's okay. It's just a spell, basically, which... We're in the market for a spell. No. They probably have a counter spell. They just don't want to seal away this. They want to hit like a... They'd rather counter a... Yeah. So that's not bad. We're getting a negate out of their hand. Hopefully this is a tap land. Tap land so we can hit Karn at least. I'm definitely not going to put my opponent on double negate. And if they do have double negate, and they have double negate. We're beating down with Scrap Dad. I'm a big Scrap Heap Scrounger fan. No, it's not Corey Baumeister. They're a great shot. Oh, double negate. That's sick. Oh, that's sick. Well, at least we can't get, at least we're not going to get whatever it is. Can't even speak. We're not going to get hit with Settler Wreckage here. I've been told that I look like Corey Baumeister or Jerry Thompson. So... Probably, I should have played my land to play around Syncopate. But so we got good, we get some pressure on the board, but just gonna get a planes. I think I'm just going to get in here with one of these. My opponent, I don't really don't want to get hit with a hit with both of these to get settled. My opponent easily could have Settle the Wreckage. Cast this. Thank you very much for the follow there, Great Shot. Appreciate that. Usually stream every Wednesday night and Sunday morning. Alright, that's a win there. My opponent's gonna counterspell my bear, then we'll take it. Alright, no land for the opponent. So my opponent's on just five spells. We were on No spells. But continue to play out my lands, because if we do hit something like a Bloodfast, I'm going to want to have as many lands as possible. That's not bad. We're just going to be able to bring it back. It does effectively fog my attack, but it's odd that Invoke... I feel like a deck like that would rather play the Forsake the Wardly one, the one that cycles also. Really don't want to get Gear Hulked here, but that's probably what's going to happen. Probably should have just mulliganed my first hand. Like, I find that one of the hardest, especially after sideboard, I just want all the mana possible. Bring back Scrap Dad. Alright, cast that's not bad. Just going to continue to attack with one here. My opponent wants to settle me. They haven't shown me a settle yet, and they're 4 or 15 cards in. I'm going to hold this land because you can always play your last land the turn you need it. Should get a black source. I just want as many... Like, if I rip... Like, how I win, how I come back from this is I, like, rip a Bloodfast. My opponent, like, somehow lets it resolve, and then I just draw, like, 3 cards. The trigger on here. So my opponent definitely has Settle the Wreckage, because this is set up perfectly for Teferi plus Settle. So we're going to have to just continue to poke in with one. It's not bad. Just any spell is not bad at this point. I can play the waiting game, buddy. I mean, I can't really play the waiting game. See, right now it would be like, if I landed Bloodfast right now, it would be just game over. But just didn't quite have it. Opponent jams another Teferi. Alira. Okay. We can handle that. We have this Deadlands. So hopefully my opponent doesn't disallow the Deadlands activation. We're in it, but like just barely. I don't think this card's even that great of a sideboard card to bring in this matchup, because it's like I'm playing Ifnir Deadlands, I have my cast outs, and I have Gideon, so I'm not even sure it's worth it. If you're gonna seal away my scrap, nope. Okay, they aren't gonna seal away my scrap dog, which is great. This is why I like keeping the one Ballista in the deck, because these games go long, and if you can land a Karn or a Bloodfast, you're just gonna find it. Okay, so that means my opponent's got some way to answer this Heart of Kieran. It does suck that I'm only doing one damage a turn here. Unless it's the Wrath, what is this? I would assume this isn't going to work if my opponent just blinked it. Yeah. All right, well, we've got him down to one card. Two cards now. This isn't good. This game's probably over at this point. If they settle me, I get to at least play another one. Yeah. But now my opponent's tapping with God only knows what. I guess the moral of the story, I should have mulliganed my first hand, with the Glimmer, which is just glorious. So they went top. Top is probably even more of a nail in the coffin. God, we had down one card and then went up to five. Search, okay. I actually just have six through this. This little like limped up gimped Lyra is just coming in there. It's probably Brad Nelson's deck. Alright, I mean that's something. Hopefully it's gonna let me power through this double settle piece. Alright, we're good. We're good with this game. We are good. Yeah, and I probably just should have mulliganed my first hand. Which caught, you know, like my deck's very mana hungry, so I thought like the five lands and like a scrap scrounger, which is a really good threat, and then Karn, which is a payoff. It just was like pretty much it was a big beating. My opponent had the second negate for the Karn. But I could have probably mitigated that somehow, even if I would have mulliganed. Okay. I think this guy's a Moto Grinder. I put him on the die roll. Yes, good hand. Knight 1, 2, 3, 4, or 2, 3, 4, which is what we're looking to do. Glacial Fortress. There's that Fatal Push. I mean, it's the cost of having four of them in the main deck. Oh, he's got three colors here. Three colors is probably not great for me because this means he's going to have an easier time handling my Knight of Malice. Because I'm assuming this red's for like Harness Lightning. I'm going to jam this Gideon before combat because if it resolves, then I get another point on this Knight of Malice. What if this is like the Baral Karn deck? So my opponent doesn't have Settle Direct Command up. So I think we're just gonna smash in for seven. We can get Seal Away, but if they're disallowing this, then we're going to commit it. Okay, so that just means the Karn's going to last, which is just good for the home team. So getting in. And then we're going to get a chance to draw the Karn, I think. Or draw the Gideon. Yep, Gideon or Scrap Dad. Two good cards. That's when Karn's really good, when you flip over two great cards. Then that's when it's. Because it's kind of slow. Link. So I kind of just want to slam this Lyra. Nah, it's probably not right to do. Probably just better just continue to work this Karn. I'm gonna go up with it, just protect slow. I don't know, my opponent could be playing some burn or something in their deck. So whatever land they take, I'm just gonna still play in this tap land. The Hulk. Okay. Open commit to memory. Okay, so and then play. I already play land. We're actually gonna be able to play Karn. If Karn resolves, I can tick down and get Gideon, and then I can minus the or plus the Gideon on the Torrential Gear Hulk. which is nice. I'm also playing like a blue, white, red control deck, it appears. Okay, so there's the Karn, which they know about. So we're going to start by attacking with Lyra. Take this Gideon. Now, if my opponent. Oh, Moto's tweaking out. Okay, we're good. So, if my opponent has counterspell plus removal spell, I lose my Karn, which isn't great. So, now I can't even start working on this Karn, or working on this Torrential Gear Hulk with Ifnir Deadlands. Okay, so we just got burn spells here for days. Kind of just want to leave. Not do anything with this. Or like not kill this. I just kind of want to leave this Ixalan's Binding for like a Teferi or something. Because we can just Deadlands this Karn out of the game. Plus on that, we're gonna play Scrap Dad and Knight of Malice. God, Moto's so laggy. Okay. Should have done that. Should have sequenced that differently, I think. And I can just start shooting this, or shrinking this, if I determine that's what we should be doing. Okay. Actually, we just have six. I mean, they might play a brawl. They win bottom-bottom. I think all these control decks are pretty good matchups. We just got stomped by that last one. Drawing some cards. Alright, so let's start off with this Ixalan's Binding. And if they counter this, then I'll just bring back the cast out and then get this. This means I can't cast it. And if they can't cast it, so I did a missequence there. I should have not played my land. All right, Knight History. So I kind of want to just start working on this Gear Hulk and then getting in with this. So I think I can just actually just get attack with this thing. If my opponent blocks it, I'll just kill it with the Deadlands. My Deadlands in it anyways. Just to shrink it. So we can't really get into my planeswalkers. I mean, it's not really in the market for attacking anyways, but alright, Harness Lightning and Scrap Dad. It's never a game you really want to play. So maybe a Siege Gang Commander here could keep my opponent back in it, I think. Another Hulk, alright. That's a good hit. You know, blink of an eye, my Ixalan's Binding, probably. I gotta shuffle away one of my planeswalkers. Nope. Alright, so now we gotta rebuild a little bit here. I can just clear out the board. So let's start with this. Grab this cast out. It never feels great cast out in Gear Hulks, but we are a little bit on the ropes here. And I guess I got aggressive, and that's why, you know, in these kind of decks, you should try not to be aggressive. I'm going to take this one so that if it comes back, it's not the one that has the counters. Okay, they just scoop it up, and then we get in there. This, they just missed, which sucks. But yeah, they're dead to the Gideon. So I'm going to board this way the same way that I would the against blue-white. So I'll go like this. Cut these. Cut our Lyras. You know, I want Lyra a little bit more now that I see all, saw all the Gear Hulks. So I might change my sideboard a little bit. Because this is usually how I'll do it. We got a couple of interest Gear Hulk. And then we got the normal grind, like the six grind pack. I think I want to keep this, or keep, go with this. I don't think I want to change anything. It's kind of like my tried troop control deck, you know? Matchups there. I don't know this one well enough to know if I want to change anything a lot, but I definitely like Gideon the Trials probably a little more than Walking Ballista if they have that many Gear Hulks. Yeah, I mean, he can be out here. Kitty boy. My puppy's got so much energy, it appears. Come here, bud. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. How's the chat night tonight? How's everybody doing? I hope there's not a terrible lag. My stream view here would suggest there is. This is a great hand. There might be a little less on like the cast out plan, maybe just on like the blink plan. But they're gonna have search. They're at least gonna have Gear Hulk and search for his content in their deck. So this Invoke the Divine is gonna be good. It's gonna have targets. We're gonna start with the Knight of Malice because I don't want to run my Scrappy Scrounger into Essence yet, or Syncopate. Just gonna sequence by attacking first. Scrap Heap Scrounger. Because they counter this, then they deal with. Okay, so they're not going to do that. They're probably just sitting on a Settle the Wreckage at this point. Or then Forsake the Worldly. Okay. It's a good answer to the Scrap Dad. Now I'm going to double spell after combat. Not going to play the Karn into my opponents. Four open mana when they can just counter the Karn and then play Teferi. I'd much rather try and get on the board. And this doesn't even walk into Fumigate that bad. Okay, because like if they Fumigate my board, I land Karn, and then I can bring back one of the Scrap Heap, bring back the Scrap Heap Scrounger. So I've still got some game to that. It actually doesn't work, right? Like, they're just dead. Teferi's dead. I should have played my Ballista first so that I could shoot this. Or at least give myself the option to. I think I'm just going to play the Walking Ballista now. I don't want to walk into my Karn into a counterspell. My Karn's kind of the... Karn is kind of like the the end all, the big plan. You know, my opponent fumigates, then we, like, it's not great, but we're in decent shape. All right, we would like some more lands. Now I do think I'm gonna do I jam the Karn or do I just put another counter on this? I think I just put a counter on this. Because they have to be sitting on counter spells. This is okay, we still get in a bunch of damage. But we might get to the point where my opponent can go like Karn plus counterspell, or like Wrath plus counterspell, which isn't good. Which appears like what we're going to be doing here. Maybe I should jam the Karn. I don't know. What do you think, Philly? Should I jam the Karn?
Dead. Always jam the Karn.
It's kind of a desperation. Okay, we got it. We just didn't have anything. Alright. Two quick matches for control decks. I'm gonna go grab something. Fill my water back up. For a while. If I finish my stream, time over. Oh, I missed it. Puppy's got a bunch of energy. Even though I took him to the dog park once today, and he had a good walk. Okay. I would like to play first on the die roll. Sweet. And this hand is very good. This hand's super good on the play. There's an argument to playing planes and cycling the cast out because my mana is pretty spoken for, but I can also just do that on my second turn, providing I don't cast. If I draw a two drop, then like that's a pretty good problem to have. But I would probably should. It probably was correct to play planes to give myself the option to cycle it. All right, playing against another control deck. Yeah. And get the old Scrap Dad down. I'm not super in love with Heart of Kieran in this deck, but I do love Scrap Heap Scrounger. A lot. My opponent pausing here means they probably have both Seal Away and both Seal Away and Search for Canada. Godfrey's Gift deck. This is a tough matchup. I'm glad I have this cast out. I just need to curve out in order to win this. I'd much rather play against the control deck than play against the gift deck. This is going to be a little tougher. Okay, so they already got it and rolled up. At least we're on the play, so we're gonna be able to play, get a history down, and then depending on what my opponent puts in their graveyard, we probably can get another history down before we have to just hold up cast out. We might be able to get both these histories down and then just hold cast out up for the rest of the game. I can push the token off God of Pharaoh's Gift, right? You do create a token. It's a token, okay. So I can easily just, I can go like history again and then hold up to fatal push whatever they bring back, even though there's nothing good to bring back. So start by attacking, then play another history. And hold up fatal push. A lot of damage to take. I get punished here if my opponent like hits an angel. And if my opponent hits an angel and they get the refurbish and they like go wide with the angel. It's a little rough. I'm so excited for tonight's NBA Finals game. Go Cavaliers. I love watching LeBron James play. I'm a big LeBron James fanboy. Gosh, my computer is super laggy. Thought to rest. What are you thought to resting? I think they're just dead. They're killing a token. Okay. Now I'm just gonna push this. Now you can give them the opportunity to block. Put them to one, and then put them to dead on board a lot of different ways next turn with a cast that up for whatever they're doing. Gosh, I'm super laggy tonight. Doesn't really matter how I stack that. And I'm sure there's an actual correct way to do it, but your move, sir. You got four lethal attackers next turn. Oh, come on, Nick. Basketball's great. How are you doing today, Nick? Fumigate. Main deck Fumigate. That'll do it. That'll do. Gotta go up to five. The life too. It's not bad. It's a good one. So we're gonna play the Deadlands, hold up the Isolated Chapel. I think I still want to, yeah, we're not gonna use this ability. I think I still wanna hold, I'm not gonna cycle the cast out because my opponent's still dead in two attacks. I have this Deadlands to deal with like a little minister guy. My opponent can refurbish back just a minister, which is gonna kind of fill him back up. So it's not terrible because it gets haste. Just cast the angel, okay? And I think this is okay to cast out because it's going to give my opponent one draw step. So do you think I'm going to hit this? Like, I could just, like, they're probably going to make this a 4-3 and then trade, and then I could just bring it back. That's so slow. And they gain a bunch of life. So I think we just want to end this game. Yeah, I'm going to just draw the heart. Which means if I draw a creature, I've got two lethal threats next turn. This could go poorly, but because we're now like in a little bit of trouble. I mean, if they just hit me with whatever it is, they just refurbished this back and they're dead. So they need, I guess they need another angel, and they need it to be a 4-3. Because if I draw a creature, they then trade, gain 4 life, and then I either take 4 or 3 damage. So, I think that's the draw. Because even if they fumigate, I'll just return the O-Ring Angel. Okay. It appears like there's a huge, huge lag in the chat tonight, which is a little frustrating. I guess I can, I like to keep up some stuff while I'm streaming. This is a matchup I definitely am a little weak to. Oh, I have two windows of Moto open. Okay, so there's the angel. They hit the refurbish. Oh no. Alright, that's alright, well, we get to at least Deadlands it and then attack with our heart. So it's not, we're not dead, or we're not like, you know, my opponent's not dead, but this game is getting worse and worse the longer it goes. Because now my opponent goes up to 5 life, so if I don't top deck a creature, then they're not dead to either one of my creatures here. So slowly feels like it's slipping out. It's like we've just almost crossed the finish line. There's the gift. And there it goes. Because now they're going to gain 12 life here. Because they're going to get back Angel. Angel makes this a 6-6. Turn off auto yields. No. Excellent. I guess it didn't kill us, but my Angel's bigger. So I have to try to get this Angel of Sanctions into combat so that I can eat this God Pharaoh's gift. I probably could have just attacked with it, honestly. They would have gained 7 life. Maybe that was the play. Refurbish back another gift. Yeah, this is just slowly getting out of hand. Because now, I guess, I just block again. And then at least I have the two biggest things in the air. It's still going to be tough for my opponent to chew through this, but this is just going to find them more gas, so. This got to get back into the Lyra, right? Or I guess you could mill now. They missed. You get back another minister, and there's you're just looking for more angels at this point. Okay. So we found a way to remove this. We've actually got like two really good attacks. I mean, we do have to get insanely lucky to win this game, though. Super lucky. Oh, that game was so close. I wonder if I used my Fatal Push too hastily in the beginning of the game. I think I'm going to gladly block with this. Because at this point, I'm going to want to bring this back, exile this, and then crack them in the air. There's definitely a chance I'm losing that race, but... one more mana. So they're going to be able to come back at me for like 20 points of damage. So I gain 5 from this attack. They're going to be able to put 16 power in play. Block 4, gain. So I'm going to gain 9. Take 12. So I effectively take 3, and they take 1. That's if they attack. We're swinging in. It's not great, but I think it's like the longer this game goes, the worse it gets for us. So I think I've got to at least make an attempt. I was gonna make an attempt to finish this game off. Likely we're screwed, but because my opponent's gonna get a million looks at the O-ring Angel, or not O-ring Angel, Angel Invention. Oh, well, that's not Angel. God, that Fumigate was so nasty. I find this deck hard to sideboard against because you would think you want Duresses to handle like all their charter courses and strategy plannings and God Pharaoh's gifts and refurbishes, but then they just like play these creatures. Oh gosh. Yeah, now the game's just over. Our whole plan was revolving around our flyers. We just didn't get there with the flyers. So I don't know how to decide. I don't think I'm gonna take out what I don't want. I don't want this Ballista. I want the bindings and the cast downs. I kind of want Karn to find that stuff. It's like I know I want these to come in. I think I want these Argles to just dig me to interaction. Probably can cut some number of these pushes, even though the pushes are good against the back half of the God Pharaoh's gift stuff shenanigans. Maybe I don't even want the blood fast. Maybe this isn't like a Karn matchup. and the Bloodfast can at least dig me to what I need. I probably want my Karns on the play. I guess I can cut Lyra. Like, Lyra just gets smoked by the... Lyra just gets dominated, heads up to the 6-6 Angel. Doomfall is probably fine as well. Cut one Karn. Alright, we're gonna give this a try. I'm not really sure how to sideboard against this deck. Majority of my losses are to this deck. So maybe I should toss in the Scavenger Grounds. Even though the mana is kind of rough, there's a lot of double white cards. God, Moto is just tweaking out. Would like to play first. I would like to mulligan. I'd like to keep this hand. Settle the Wreckage might not be what I'm looking for either. It's, this deck, I just want lands. This hand, I just want lands. Because, like, I don't want Karn to dig to whatever I need. And if I want to do Karn and then be able to double spell, I'm going to need lands in order to do that. That's why I like having 25 lands in this deck. I think playing 24 is just not what we should be doing. I'm going to put that on top. Yeah, I can't put this Angel on the bottom. Well, I probably was supposed to bottom that. Hopefully hit like a 2-drop. God, my Moto is just losing its mind tonight. It was so wrong to top this, because I have to just hit like runner lands in order to make this work, and I just was talking about how I need lands. That was stupid. Which is not the right thing to do on my part. There's the gift. Already in the graveyard. Yeah. See, now we're gonna brick off and die. If that's the case, that's what I deserve to have happened. Okay, opponent missed a land drop. Yeah, see, I deserve this. I deserve it for sure. I've played so many lands, but I should play to that deck. If the deck needs lands, then I should play to myself drawing lands and put my 5-drop on the bottom. Drawn 3 spells, which is good, but yeah, you got it, dude. So if I can draw out of it, my hand's actually pretty good. In this matchup, I got Settle. There's Shalai, which is not good. Opponent did hit their land drop. All right. Well, at least I'm gonna play that. I have a play this turn. And our opponent probably didn't top deck that land. Like, our opponent probably has 7 spells in their hand. This would suggest that as well. So if they were to go Refurbish into Gift into Shalai, that's gonna be tough. Especially considering Shalai shuts off Settle. But draw land, I can Ixalan's binding it, but I want to binding the God Pharaoh's Gift. Champion wins. So that's gonna get them the land they need. And then I'm just going to attack and hold up Invoke the Divine. Like, I've got enough here to probably just stay patient. Wow, that didn't hit the land. And we didn't either. I mean, they might not have hit the land. They might have hit it and they're not showing it for some reason. But we can still divine it. My opponent does need a lot next turn and just not die. A card like Fairgrounds Warden would actually do a pretty decent job here. Because it would just kill a guy and then chump block. What an odd game. Want Refurbish, Godfrey's Gift. That is what we are looking for, and then we just want to kill him. Listen, probably, I doubt they'll do it if they have the option to them, but their best play is probably just Fairgrounds Warden. Fairgrounds Warden, smoke one of these, and then chump block. Then we just kind of do it all again next turn. I wonder what they're thinking about. This seems like a pretty easy... You don't have a lot of options. Maybe they've got the Fairgrounds Warden. I mean, it wouldn't be like way out of the realm of possibility for my opponent to go like... They haven't played land forever. They've just got nothing but interaction. Yeah, it looks like that's what, I'm gonna assume that's what my opponent did. Now, if we draw land, we likely kill them. If we don't draw land, then my opponent's in the same position next turn. Lyra and Fumigate. So they must have another Fumigate rolled up. Like they're or else you keep this. Oh, man. I have a feeling if my opponent has a land, we're about to get Fumigated. I think I signed out my walking blisters. Yep. So I have two and I have no reach. Awesome. Yeah, here it comes. Here comes the Fumigate. Man. Now we're probably just dead. It's like I can't even. It's like, do I even play this? They have five cards. So like I've got to get something going on. I just have to hope they have nothing for the rest of the game. That's rough. Now they're gonna gain 4 million life. And we have to answer this, not pressure the board. They're gonna bring back this Lyra, this angel, and just crack me for 6 in the air. And then it's gonna be die next turn. Because I've gotta kill this thing. Very unfortunate turn events for the home team. It's another angel. Right on time. So I think now I'm just gonna. I can binding something else. I guess I might as well just gain my life while I can. And then hopefully we have the tools to win here. It does suck that it just opens up to get refurbished again. Yeah, we're just... because I wanted to binding this. Yeah, we're... Yeah, that's unfortunate. That was tough. It's like if we hit the fourth land there, we kill him on the spot. It's a bad matchup, I think. I think the God Pharaoh's deck get, like, the majority of the time that I lose, I've been doing pretty well with this deck. A majority of the time, most of my losses, I think, I guess not most because I don't play against it enough, but quite a few of the matches come at the hands of the God Pharaoh's gift decks. I wonder what happened. I guess the blue-red God Pharaoh's gift deck gets Chain Whirlered. Play. Sounds okay. We're gonna need lands, but hopefully they come. We play 25 of them, so we got two. We can operate off two here. We're gonna lead on the Heart of Cure and then play the Scrap Dad and start getting in there. This is a, you know, a little thing, but from what I changed recently, like there were four cast outs, and I changed two of the cast outs to Ixalan's bindings. So Glinsleeve Siphoner, okay. We have a super aggressive hand though, so. Hopefully we can at least punish this awkward siphoner draw from our opponent. If we have a land, I might kill this. But if they don't have four, if they don't get another energy, then I might save this for like a Scarab God. Because I'm worried about Scarab God out of this deck. But I like playing this deck. Doom follow me, okay. They might just take the binding. Doomfall is such a cool card. Just does a little bit of everything. My Angel Sanctions, okay? Tilt. Man, we've been having some land problems tonight, but. Jeez. Computer is so laggy tonight. Probably because my wife's here. Usually she's out of here on Saturdays, or on Wednesdays. Really looking for a land here. The land means Karn. Then we have a pretty big time attack. God. If this gets fatal push, then at least my opponent doesn't draw a card, which is nice. because they don't draw a card. What? They drew a card. What did they? Oh, no, they didn't. Okay. They just drew their one. Okay, they have five cards. I thought they drew, and I'm like, didn't they lose an energy? Like, what is that? I might have to shut this down here before the next game here. Because I am lagging all over the place. I'm just going to, like, play a Scarab God. No, okay. Thank the Lord. So I think I'm just going to bindings this. Prevent this thing from running away with the game. Then my opponent slams another Scarab God and I can bind him that. Hopefully they were just sandbagging the God. So Aetherborn's doing some damage though. Yeah, here it comes. All right, now if we can get to this Lyra, we should be able to take this game over. Because especially, I mean, worst comes to worst, we just play the Knight next turn, and the Knight holds off that Gifted Aetherborn. I can't get to the curb. Just get out of here. That's where Nick Cook draws the line. It's starting to get dark. Drew another Scarab God? No, he just, okay. Alright. So, I kind of just want to play Karn and make a 2-2. Because my opponent knows. Nah, I think I'm going to be mana efficient. I think I'm just going to jam this Lyra. My opponent knows about it. They don't know about Karn. If I draw a land, I can go Karn plus Knight next turn. So I think we're going to get in this, because the old scrap heap scrounger does not do a very good job on defense. And now we're just going to hope that this works here. All right, there's one card. Appears like it's going to work. This trade's here. Oh, they're leaving that out there. Okay. Now, I know Kevin Jones played one Yeheni's Expertise against this deck. In this deck, when he played it, and that was the version that was on camera. So I think it's probably the most popular one. So I think I'm just going to jam the Karn. Now that my opponent's got a pretty weak board. This is already lethal. I guess by that, I should have just ran. Put this out here. Yeah, I just went backwards on my logic, not thinking. Because this is already lethal, so Yeheni's Expertise doesn't even do it. Unless they went like Yeheni's Expertise into Doomfall. But it's also just low opportunity cost, I think, to having the Karn. Like, having the Karn going against this blue-black deck is good. Anyways. So, like, now we're coming at him from a couple different angles. I wonder what other card I exiled. Okay. So let me look at my sideboard thing here. So against the blue black deck. So I like cutting these, they're just pretty low impact. I don't like the Angel of Sanctions. I only really like one layer X doesn't do anything. I Like shaving on these. And then bring it in here. I like the Eldest Reborn, the Two Bloodfast, the boat, the two boats, because they tend to like flood the board with a bunch of little creatures that are hard to trade with. And they have a lot of removal. So it's nice to, I like coming over the top here with this boat. Especially it helps deal with Liliana a lot. So these two, then one Doomfall, and then two Duresses. We still have four answers to Siphoner on turn two. So, and Fatal Push is kind of like, it's just a little low impact throughout, overall, I think. I think it's only really good there to kill Siphoner. God, I hope I get to resolve the Eldest Reborn. That's like my favorite card out of the sideboard. All right, Duress into Threat. This is how we drew it up. A little soft to Glintsleeve Siphoner, but it's a great draw. That kind of sucks, putting a Never to Return in the graveyard. Currently don't have an answer to the old Scarab God. We gotta get out ahead of this Scarab God. Probably gonna cycle this. Probably means they drew another land because you really want to hit the Scarab God on time, I think. This deck is very much, it seems like a Scarab God deck. It's Champion Wits. No, they're just gonna field it ruin. So we're gonna get a white source off of this. All right, there's the bows and hoes. So we do get to crack our opponent for seven. Then we get to just attack in again and play the boat. And the boat will help deal with the Scarab God. This might find an answer to it, which it didn't really. Wow, they just scoop it on up. All right. Could have made a construct, I guess. Construct would have been 3-4 block. Construct wouldn't have killed him unless I drew a removal spell. Because the whole plan was to just attack next turn. They probably block the Scrap Dad. And then we boat the Sky Saw. Boat it. We boat it. And then we hit it with the boat. And then it heads back to their hand. And we just kind of put them back. Oh, we already up here. I wish Nikes. This is going to be my last game of the day. I just wanted to get a short little video. A short little one up here and get it on YouTube. So this is going to be the last one because I really want to watch the Cavs. Alright, we're going to keep this even though this is ugly. If we draw a basic land, then this hand's pretty good. But it's going to, like these tap lands are going to suck. Alright, wrong deck to have tap lands against. Definitely gotta push this thing. Like, this thing's such a, like, with how our hands lining up here, like, History of Benalia is really good against the red deck. We just need to not get Chain Whirlered. And Chain Whirler plus Soul Scar Mage really invalidates History. So, even though this is kind of mopey, this thing is a real threat. And does just have to die on the spot. swamp, that would be great. Alright, plains is just as good. Come on. Why can't I? Alright, let's see if we can play something in our second main phase. Sorry, let me play the swamp. This plains, what is going on here? Oh. A little bit of OBS issues. Why can't I play this? Okay, there we go. So I'm going to play history because I don't want my opponent to just on-crop Crasher into my Gideon. And it's just good to get this card working here. Yep, we'll take that. It's not as good for us as they're oftentimes like... Yeah, see, this is what we even want. As oftentimes they are emptying their hand to hazard us. So we're just going to get this out before we play Karn, because if they have another on-crop Crasher, then they're going to kill Karn. So just want to play it slow, play board control. It says we're having some OBS issues, but let's hope that redoes itself. Alright, we are live now. I've even thought about going up to 26 lands with this deck. Okay, so this is some big bomb. At least we can deal. Yeah, so now this is why I really like Ixalan's Binding. No, 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 no. Turn off auto yields. I almost hit into there. Yeah, I mean, that's it ended up costing that. Oh, I clicked out of that. That's just like the lag sent me through there. Yeah, so we're going to plus on this. Ixalan's Binding the Hazoret. Play this land. And now we're like slowly getting out of this. It's kind of frustrating that like motoed out of it, but that is moto. Yeah, they just scoop it up there. They understand they're a bit too far behind. That's just like what this deck, when this deck works, what it does is it just creates like board control. So okay, so let me pull up my mono red. So against mono red, I usually just cut my four Scrap Heap Scroungers, and then I bring in Cast Down, Doomfall, Angel of Sanguine, and Cellar Wreckage. If I see they go really big, sometimes I cut two Hearty Cairns and bring the boats in. But that'll be definitely something we look to do on the play if they're going really big. Something like the standard problem is that, you know, Chain Whirler is such a beating. And the boat kind of lines up pretty decently against Chain Whirler, because, I mean, it's late, but it just comes down and boom, smokes it. Which can be difficult to this deck to do without, because like the only good ways to answer after Cyborg really is this card. Or to just interact with it on the ground. Just block it. And it can be tough to block. It's a 3/3 first striker. You know, like it's big. I think I'm going to play this deck in the mocks this weekend on Saturday if I don't have to work. Which, let's hope I don't have to. They're putting True Day Nemesis from Battlebond back into the... They're putting the Battlebond cards into the treasure chests. So they should jump up in value. So all of my chests that I've been saving right here when the old slow moto wants to do its thing. Oh, my opponent's got plays. Okay. We're going to keep this hand because this card is that good and these two cards are that good and this is also very good. So like our hand's pretty good. We'd like it if this Ixalan's Binding or this Lyra Dawnbringer were lands. But Ixalan's Binding is also just aces against against these red decks, against these red black decks. It's why some people don't play four cast outs. Is because the Ixalan's Binding just, because they're all play three and four of, is just such a beating. Yeah, I wonder why we're lagging. Like, according to my handy dandy internet speed test, we should be in good shape. But such is life. That's a great draw. All we want, this hand's really good. All we need is lands. We don't even necessarily need the fourth land on time because we're just going to like history them out of the game. It's another pretty good draw. Kind of sucks we got to take a point off of this, but nothing's perfect. I would assume this dies. My opponent doesn't have a two drop. Like, they had to keep their hand for some reason. We're just going to survive to that Lyra. Survive to the Dawnbringer. Yep, we knew that was going to happen. This comes a chain gang, probably. We're just going to start working this history. We could trade for this, but we might get more. We might get like a Hazard or an Accumulating Phoenix out of this Doomfall. Okay. If we hit a land, it's going to be really good for the home team. It's not land. So I can play another one, or I can play Heart of Kieran and hold up Fatal Push. But I'd have to push this Kenra. I think it's better to go Heart and then hold up Fatal Push, because like I want to get these off the battlefield. If I can somehow like trade for this, or I'm going to try to crew this, and I'm going to try to block this thing here. If I do get to block it, and then I can push this, and then I can actually deal with this Earthshaker Kenra for us. Oh my god, I just like clicked through while I was talking here. Turn off audio. No. Then F6 through that. It's just a comic... Just a comedy of errors. So it's going to come back as a 4-4. But if I block this, then I can push this and get in. So opponent probably definitely has the land. The nice thing is that we can deal with this Earthshaker a couple different ways. We missed out on 2 points of damage, which is pretty big here. And if they tap five to put this, six to put this Kenra out, we're just going to chump it and then Doomfall it. Just can't take 4 points from this thing. I love how History of Benalia plays offense and defense. It's a good draw. Then we got Binding. Yeah, we have plenty of plays next turn, so we should be in good shape. My opponent's flooding out pretty badly, which definitely sucks. They're probably sitting on something like a Fight with Fire, if I had to assume. So we gotta kill them before that gets off. Which is next turn. So, and the Fight with Fire costs 9. We've got them through a blocker. It's a Chain Gang. We have a double Chain Gang. That would be so bad. Alright, well, I think we're just gonna go for it. It's been like a comically poor draw from my opponent. Alright. Probably, definitely. Yes, I do say that. Okay. Let's open up our Moto. Open up all these. Nice. Incendiary Flow. Okay. So I like this deck a lot. This deck fits to the playstyle, my playstyle a little bit. I think it's a little weak to the God Pharaoh's Gift deck. So I think that in our next league, I'm probably going to shuffle something around where maybe I cut like a Plains and a Swamp for a Forsaken Sanctuary and a Scavenger Grounds. And then see if I can find something to maybe switch in this graveyard around. I'm really not, I don't really like the Settle the Wreckage very much in this deck. Like this card's very easy to play around, and in all of these grindy mirrors, it just allows people to explode with mana. So I could see cutting this for a card that's good against God Pharaoh's Gift. Maybe something that's a little Silent Gravestone also can bring in against the Silent Gravestone. Can't bring it in the mirror. I can bring it in against just Gearhulk decks, really. And I guess maybe like Scarab God decks. But then I can't do anything with my Scrap Heap Scroungers, which are also very good in those matchups. So I'm not sure. I am not sure. I could also see cutting one of these Scrap Heap Scroungers for another Ballista. I'm just playing 3 Ballistas, but Ballista could be too slow. Like, my deck's already kind of slow and plotty, and I do want to be able to attack. We saw it against the control decks. Like, the first time playing against the control deck, I just didn't really have a lot going on. Though I kept a bad hand in game 2, but game 1, I just didn't have a lot going on. But anyways, I think we're going to call it for the night. I appreciate everybody for showing up and hanging out. If you guys like what you see, please hit the follow button. I will be back on Sunday. I might stream the mocks on Saturday. It'll depend on what my wife's and I's schedule is. But we'll have to see that. We'll figure that out later. So appreciate you showing up, Nick, and I hope you all have a good rest of your night.